Welcome to everyone. It's my pleasure to be here today. I wanted to let you know that I am working in collaboration with Living Education to present this coding update today. First is parenthetical notes. I mentioned that earlier. The parenthetical notes are kind of bothering me. Can you tell it's slowing me down? It's making me reread everything in the book to make sure that I'm doing this correctly. And this is the first one that kind of hit me. If you have your book in front of you, this makes the presentation go much better because then you can follow along with your code. 1725 in the integumentary system is for the code for chemical cauterization of granulation tissue. Now this code has a triangle in front of it, which means, of course, it's been revised. So I looked and said, well, what's the difference between last year's code and this year's code? Well, you'll notice in parentheses is proud flesh, i.e. proud flesh. Last year, it also included sinus or fistula. Okay, what does that mean exactly? Well, proud flesh, first of all, the clinical piece that comes to this is granulation tissue is normal. It's what your body does to heal itself when it has a wound. But what you see on the screen is not normal. This is overgrowth of granulation tissue, and it's often called proud flesh. This is of the finger. And I promise you, this is the only gory picture I have in the presentation today, but for a visual, it does do its job, so you know what this looks like. There's also an English lesson in here for us. That IE in English, and I always get those confused. I have to look it up every now and then. IE versus EG. IE means that is. That means it's declaring. This is your code for proud flesh. EG means for example. So what it's telling me is it's narrowing our use of this code to just over granulation. Too much tissue, you've got to clean it up with a chemical cauterization. Now, there's more to the story on the next slide, because not only does this teach us a little about English and editing, look what happened to this code in the parenthetical area. There's three of them that are new this year. And what each of them tells us is that don't try to use this code, 17250, for removal of a lesion, same lesion. In other words, they're trying to limit this use to just the chemical cauterization, not a cleanup after they've excised a lesion. Also, don't try to report this code to achieve hemostasis, in other words, stop the bleeding. No. Doctors will use this technique to stop bleeding sometimes, and they're telling us, nope, that's not this code, 17250. And don't report it with those 97 codes back in the back in the medicine section, which are for debridement. So what this is telling me is CPT is trying very hard to provide guidance for use and to put with these exclusions. And interesting, I looked at the rationale for this, and it said a committee, sure enough, reviewed the code for high volume growth. So I'm sure this kind of editing is going to continue. So be careful when, and quite frankly, we're going to need software applications to help us with these and hopefully editing tools because it's kind of a daunting task. If you're interested in a longer version of this, Living Education, which has always been a great partner for me, I've developed a course, it's about 2 hours long, 2 CEUs, and it's going to include more case studies, some operative notes for application of everything you've seen today, plus some more about parenthetical notes, and also some movies and videos that help the clinical piece of understanding these codes.